sums brothers, and she's here doing one of her songs herself. We welcome Jessie J.
Today we're looking at Price Tag by Jessie J, the acoustic version with the original guitar arrangement by Ben Martinez. It's a great song, Price Tag, but an unusual song in the sense it only has four chords that we play in sequence from the very start to the very finish. So when Ben was looking at the acoustic arrangement, I think he figured out pretty quickly that if you just played those four chords over and over again, there would be a real danger that the piece could end up sounding quite repetitive and a little bit dull. So it's quite interesting what he's done. It's a good study of how a professional musician approaches something a problem like this, because he obviously keeps the same chords, but he plays them in different positions on the fretboard and with different voicings on the verses and on the choruses, and in that way he actually makes two distinct sounds, really, even though we are playing the same root chords. So let's look at the chords on the verses. They all revolve around bar chords on the 5th and on the 6th frets. And you'll notice that they're much jazzier, the chords on the verses, than they are on the choruses. And that's to do with the voicings that that Ben uses, especially the use of minor 7 chords. We're going to start with the first chord, the F. So we need to bar the 5th fret. But to get our bass note, we actually want to be on the 2nd string on the 8th fret. That's where we find the bass note. So although we've barred all 6, actually we do keep this bottom string muted, and we only play it from the 2nd string downwards. We then also bring on the ring finger, and that goes onto the 3rd string on the 7th fret. And then we also bring on the middle finger, and that's up on the 5th string on the 6th fret, just there, and it sounds like this. That's the F chord. Maybe quite new to some of you, that particular position to play an F chord. You're probably more likely to have played an F chord as a bar chord up there, but it's quite important that you persevere and learn that one. It is a little bit of a stretcher, I'm not going to lie to you, but try and persevere with it, because it's a really good relationship with the next chord, which is also barred on the 5th fret, and it's an A minor 7. Now there's various different ways to play an A minor 7 chord. It's a very versatile one in terms of the guitar, but the way Ben used it is he brings the thumb over the top of the fretboard here to hit the 5th fret on the 1st string, and the 2nd string is left open, which is also an A, so you kind of get a double bass note there, but it sounds really nice. And the rest of the chord is just barring from strings 3 down to right up to the top string. So that's the chord, A minor 7. Sounds really nice. And we're still barring on the 5th chord, on the 5th fret rather, for the next chord, which is a D minor 7. And this time we are going to bring the ring finger up onto the 3rd string at the 7th fret, and then the middle finger comes up on the 5th string on the 6th fret. And again on this one we're going to keep this E string muted, because our bass note here is the D, which we find on the bar chord there, but on the 2nd string at the 5th fret, so we play from there downwards. That's our D minor 7. And then finally the A sharp is a kind of conventional bar chord. So we're now up on the 6th fret. And then we put the ring finger on the 2nd string, and that goes on to fret 7. The little finger is also on the 7th fret on the 3rd string. And then the middle finger is on the 4th string, and that's on the 6th fret. That's your A sharp. And there's one final thing to show you before we go back to the F. He plays a slash chord, which it gets its name from the way you see it written down on tabs and so forth. But just before going back to the F, what he does, he actually with the ring finger there, he then bars the first three strings on the 7th fret. And it's effectively an A sharp with a C bass note. That's kind of why you've got the slash there. So it's an A sharp with a C bass note. So it goes from there to there, and then we're back to the F. I think the reason he did that is sort of alludes to the bass line in the record, which sort of goes. So you're going up to that C note there before going to the F, and it sounds really great. And then you're back to the F, and off we go again. So that's the four chords. We better look at the strumming pattern for that. Strumming is the most difficult thing to teach, really, because unlike chords where you can write a tab down with the notes you need to play, it's really strumming. It's all about using your ears, listening to the record, and finding the groove. And an exercise that I use, which works for me, and hopefully it'll work for you as well, is really to sort of try and turn your guitar into sort of percussive instrument, really, when you're practicing, because it's all about rhythm and groove and so forth. And so the technique I use for it is I kind of dampen the strings, so you get this sort of rhythmic sound. And then I think it helps focus, really, because rather than worrying about the chords you're playing and hitting the right notes and all that sort of thing, when you're learning the rhythm pattern, just concentrate on that and really try and get into the rhythm by using this technique. So just sort of put your fingers over the top of the strings without actually playing a chord, so you get that sound, and then really listen to the record and pick up the rhythm. So it's kind of like this. Try that and see how you get on, but this is how the rhythm sounds when you play the chords. Show you just before we go on to have a look at the chorus is, we've learnt really the basic template to the song now. But Ben does use these little sort of flourishes, really, which again just makes the whole thing sound a little bit better, particularly on the D minor 7 chord. You'll hear this, but he'll bring the middle finger on and off the position, like hammering on and off. And similarly, he'll bring the little finger on as well onto the top note, onto the 6th string, up there on the 8th fret. It's actually the same chord. If I play D minor 7 there, D minor 7 with that, it is absolutely the same chord, but you've just got this extra higher note there. When he's playing D minor 7, he'll play things like this. And again, that just gives the piece its sound. It's not absolutely not essential, but once you're really quite familiar with the pattern, you might want to just practice some of these. So listen out for it now in the context of the whole sequence. So there we are. Okay, so now we're going to look at the chorus. We start with the F, which we play in the traditional position, if you like, with a bar on the first fret, and then we bring on our ring finger onto the second string at the third fret. The little finger is also on the third fret, that's on the third string as well. And then the middle finger is on the second fret, and we're playing the fourth string. That's an F, which chord will be familiar to most of us, I'm sure. And then we go to an A minor, and this time no minor 7 like we had in the verse, it's a straightforward A minor chord, and we should be playing our bass note really, so we keep the first string muted. We want to play the A there on the second string, that's our bass note. And then we have our middle finger is now on the second fret, third string, and the ring finger also on the second fret on the fourth string, and the index finger is on the fifth string on the first fret. A minor chord, and then a D minor chord, again not a minor 7, just a straightforward D minor. Bass note really should be the third string, the open D, and that's our bass note. And then this time we have the middle finger on the second fret, and that's on the playing on the fourth string. The ring finger is up on the third fret on the fifth string, and then the index finger is on the top string, the sixth string, on the first fret. And that's our D minor. Now when it comes to the A sharp on the chorus, Ben again alters the voicings. On the chorus he plays an A sharp sus 2, and to play that chord we bar the first fret, but our bass note is going to be the A sharp, so that's on the second string on the first fret. And then the other fingers that we bring into play are the ring finger and the little finger, and they're both on the third fret, and they're playing strings 3 and 4, and that's an A sus 2, A sharp sus 2 I should say. So that's the voicing that he uses there. And if you remember, we had that slash chord. That's still in play in the chorus. It's an A sharp sus 2 slash C. So we've got a C note. To get that, again, a little bit of a stretch of this one, but the one finger you've got free at the moment is the middle finger, and you need to bring that onto the C note, which of course we find on the second string at the third fret. And that's what it sounds like when you're playing it in the slash chord. And then we're back to the F again. So altogether it sounds like this. And that gets repeated twice. And then we're back then you're back to where you were on the verses again, and off we go. So we've really learnt the main parts there. The only other variations in the song, of course, are towards the end, where the guitar and Jesse's voice sort of kind of play with one another. Really, there are sort of breaks that come into it with the when they're playing the la 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 bit, etc. But it's all revolving around the same chords. So, for instance, some of the breaks would sound like this. Etc, etc. And that goes on right to the end. The final piece of the song, in fact, it just gets slowed right down, the tempo, before we hit the ending, so it kind of sounds like this. That we've learnt before. So that's Price Tag.